had no real ambition in this Paris, Roubaix. The least that can be said is that you didn't prove the forecasters wrong.
Hello. Now it's time for the Paris Roubaix. It's gonna be so exciting. This is basically mine after the 15th place. God, the Flandern Tour. So crazy. So, here we go. We actually got 97 points for that. So, it can climb in the ranks. Of course, we should not get the weather's actually not that bad for this couple zones. Again, of course, Quintana, no way. On court, of course. Cow. It's a strong team we actually gotta get in this criterion. Paris-Roubaix. Here we go. Paris-Roubaix. The health of North.
Hi guys. Welcome to this Paris-Roubaix briefing. Do I really need to talk about the profile? I think everybody knows it. 250 kilometers over flat terrain with 50
so
kilometers
we're gonna get to this top 5 place with Van Aert, but we also have to do it after that 15th place in the Flandern Classic. We have something to do after this. Of course, Sagan is favorite, no doubt about it, and Simon van Aert and Lassen, but we also have Van Aert. And we have a lot of the things we have to do here. Objectives. course, we're going to go in a breakaway from the beginning and see Van Aert, Bosenhagen, on score. So, strong guys we had with us.
Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to one of the main events of the cycling season, the mythical Paris-Roubaix. With its flat terrain and numerous cobbled sectors, this classic offers an atypical route where a rider's condition is as important as luck if he is to hope for victory.
And we need to have a guy with us, and it should probably be... And... Van Aert has been protected by a cord. Valgren should protect Bosenhagen. Just 50%. There's need for him to actually get too much pressure on. 256 kilometers. It's gonna be a tough day at the office. At least this time we are allowed to go on a breakaway. We didn't allow that in the Flandern tour. They didn't let us go. Created by the cobblestones, it's not uncommon to see the morning breakaway hold off the favorites for the best part of the race, and sometimes even. And we are ready here. Car should be ready to go here. Van Aert, Bosenhagen, probably favorites. To get this, because we need to get it first to the first few sectors. We can get some points for our own rider experience.
They're stepping on the pedal at the front of the peloton.
It's not a rider I would see is dangerous, but Carl Andersen. Continue attacking from behind. That just makes us wonder, should we put this on? Yes. Not the more the merrier. And we are just trying to make a high speed. This way we can make sure we are getting enough gap.
Of extraordinary endurance to hope for a win today.
Right now, Carl, we should just take it easy, and he's well, take it easy.
Okay, I'll follow any attack.
The peloton is running fast, of course, it's quick step. Enough. This gap should be enough. Let's see. Knees in the breakaway. Strong guy for the cobblestones. Unni. So fairly good. Mass. He's also good, but it's not a guy I cannot beat. Also. Garcia. Let's see how many riders are in this breakaway, who actually can be a threat. It's not a problem either. It's not a problem. Of course, he's our helper, and me. And we actually the worst cobblestone rider, these riders in this breakaway at this point. So that's why it's so important we're gonna get these riders up. So you set a high pace.
It is not always a good idea to be too many in a breakaway, as the others will not necessarily want to cooperate with us.
Come on, guys.
Bravo de gap.
Brilliant.
Okay, I'll follow any attack.
Should be ready. Prop this. Coming at tech soon.
Come on, guys.
The first 100 kilometers are of little interest, and are often used as an observation round by the favourites in order to see which team will take the race in hand.
He's got his teammates riding because he no doubt finds that the breakaway is too big. If you're feeling strong, attack to create a smaller group.
I'll put in a big acceleration.
A good ruler, he doesn't really have a strong point that would scare opponents.
I'll take it easy on the relay.
Here we go.
Watch out for him. Is a real puncher, can come out on top on any finish with a short climb, but he can also rely on a good turn of speed if there's a group finish. Both puncher and ruler, he can rely on his pace if he reaches the finish in a small group.
I'll take it easy on the relay.
Hello, Luis Matos.
Okay, I'll put in a big acceleration.
There's an attack behind. He's a rider who can put in a long day's ride. He has no real strengths or weaknesses except the mountains.
I'll relay.
I love it. Come on, guys.
He's primarily a teammate ruler, even if he's not too bad on a sprint.
Seems like they got this group split in two half,
yes,
but for the moment.
Okay, I'm coming to protect you.
Should be a few of these guys that should struggle soon.
Allez, courage les gars, allez plus vite.
make a big effort on the relay. Don't let the counterattack catch up. The peloton won't let such a large group get away.
Here we go, here we go!
Two guys to set a pace now. That'll probably be the best. Let's take it easy now. Just stay behind.
Okay, I'm coming to protect you.
Don't let us go.
Good sprinter, but doesn't have too much
problem. Too much to peak up. At least not for now. Also hard to see how much distance you should give you.
He's a good sprinter, often used as lead out rider to drive mass sprints.
Still 60 kilometers. To the most important sector.
Okay, we'll avoid any extreme effort.
Just stay behind now.
Guys, yeah, come on. Come on, team. got his teammates riding because he no doubt finds that the breakaway is
swing your people.
If you're feeling strong, attack to create a smaller group.
Yeah. Let's wait to see what's happening. And Arty is actually a strong guy. Old helper. Old sprinter actually. Also old helper for control. Let's do some action. Tempo.
Okay, I'll consume a feed. Got his teammates riding because he no doubt finds that the breakaway is too big. If you're feeling strong, attack to create a smaller group.
It's gonna be soon. See what they say to this. They're actually going to react on this.
He's a pretty good ruler and has decent sprint capabilities.
Looks like he's got his team riding to catch up with the counterattack. I'm not sure that it's worth you continuing your exertions.
He's one of the rulers with a good top speed, able to do well on the hilly stages.
Try and hinder relay. Essentially, you're the fastest of the group in a sprint.
Come on, guys!
Here we go, here we go!
I'll make a big effort on the relay.
Allez, les gars, go on! Bravo, les gars!
Allez, allez-y, haut rein! Bye!
Ihr schafft das!
Haltet euch, ihr schafft!
Thank you.
Soon the first couple sections. Probably the most important cover sections in history of the team. Figure out who's actually good form and who's not, who's about to drop off.
Well, on flat stages, that's not where you see the most drama. You can accelerate forward if you think that nothing important.
It's nothing about.
Constantly try to shelter from the wind so as not to consume energy. This is what allows a rider to edge clear at the end of the race. Jeez. They're riding hard behind. This isn't the moment to relax.
Woo, yeah! Whoa, excellent!
Allez!
On continue.
Bravo,
comme ça.
Les gars!
Continue comme ça.
The first sectors of cobblestone are approaching. While it is still too early to make any big moves, the pace of the race should accelerate.
Later. Thank you. for a sixth today.
We're off. The riders are onto the first sector.
Hey, Peter.
From Traville to Inchy, 2,200 meters of cobblestones.
Jeg fik 15. pladsen på Flanderen. The last sector bears the number one. Ja. Jeg blev først sat af de sidste 5 km. Den sidste bakke, der var. Men det er fordi, jeg prøvede at angribe tidligt i løbet. Men det fik jeg ikke lov til. Så jeg brugte så meget udvendig energi der, og det vidste jeg ikke jo. Jeg regnede ikke med, at jeg var en af favoritterne jo. Eller en af dem, som de vil regne som favorit. Men det er fordi, det går mere på bakketerræn og ikke brosten jo. Og det tænker jeg ikke over. På 69. Men det er fordi, der er så mange bakker også jo. Så det var det, der gør forskellen. Det tænker jeg ikke over. Så jeg brugte næsten 70 meter på at angribe. Jeg burde køre taktisk, så man ikke kører fandme så ud. Jeg kunne godt køre taktisk bare på en anden måde. Men der var det lidt for sent. Og fandme er, at han var i dårlig form der, så han skulle hjælpe mig. Between the end of the first one and the beginning of the next.
Breakaway companions look like they want to up the pace.
The head of the race is onto the first four-star sector, more than 3,400 meters long and ending in a rising false flat. Some riders could already be in difficulty.
Ja, vi vil godt prøve bagefter. Men jeg vil ikke helt lige spille det, jeg skal lige ned, når kæresten kommer tilbage, hun er lige nede til sol. Så skal jeg lige ned og gå 100 km. Så. Og hvis du stopper kl. 10, så... Åh, det ved jeg ikke. Hun skal først hjem, jo. Jeg er ikke lige, når hun kommer tilbage. Hun kørte for 10 minutter siden. Jeg er kvarteret siden. Der er lige 20 minutter til sol, tror jeg. Hvordan? Jeg får se. Se min hold. Rigtig brostenhold, jeg har her. Rigtig brostenhold.
Understood. We'll take it easy, whatever happens. Okay, we'll consume a feed.
Ja, det gør ingen forskel.
A new sector, number 25, also quite long with its 3,000 meters of cobblestone.
Jeg er faktisk på 13 sejre i weekenden. Altså, det er sådan svært. Jeg var faktisk oppe på allerede 11 sejre efter 22 kampe, altså. Så gik jeg bare, så gik det bare lidt dårligt. Så vandt jeg en, så tabte 3. Så vandt jeg en, så tabte 3 igen. Jeg var på 13 sejre. Det er jo ikke kommet 14.
At the end of the next sector, the riders will reach the first feed zone. A few moments of rest before facing the remaining 23 sectors.
Det er ikke 40.000, det er ikke så galt. Spillerne koster ikke næsten ikke noget. Og lige så gør de. Ja, det er også lige meget 24 udkommer om måneden, jo.
True sprinter who's not too bad of a short climb. Beware of him in the sprint.
Tøj, stop. Læg dig.
From Vertin to Saint-Martin-sur-Écaillon, a 2,300-meter sector is awaiting the riders.
Rebel Distiller on me. Crazy. That's crazy.
Okay, I'll protect him.
If I could get 5 minutes gap, I would actually say that this could hold all the way. Not for me, but maybe for another rider. That would be funny.
If the first sectors have already scattered the peloton, the race between the favorites should only start from the trench of Arenberg, a mythical sector that has entered 95 kilometers from the finish.
Choose in the middle of nowhere. There must be a dead end.
The sector is approaching for the front of the race. This is the first in a sequence of three sectors that will come one straight after the other, making for almost 6 kilometers of road with that tarmac. Time difference between the peloton and the breakaway is steady.
I'll take it easy now. No need for me to rush it.
Breakaway is losing ground.
Yeah, it's not bad.
Okay, I'll protect him. He's gone down. His teammates will no doubt wait for him.
Wow, do you no doubt? I doubt they would. Keep falling, oh, one by one.
to protect you.
Flat stages. Little stages, okay. Well, this is not a flat stages.
In less than 10 kilometers, the first riders will be on to the trench of Arenberg, first key sector for the favorites of this Paris-Roubaix. But beforehand, they will have to cross the demanding Havre-Louis to Wallers sector, classified as 4 stars.
Avoid any extreme effort.
Another 100 kilometers for the front of the race. Tension will soon be at its maximum. With the trench of Arenberg coming up in a few kilometers, now's the time to move to the front.
Understood. I'll take it easy, whatever happens.
Its true name being Drève de Boule d'Airain, the trench of Arenberg is 2,400 meters long. Obviously classified as 5 stars, it's a mythical Paris-Roubaix site, which, if it does not decide...
is riding hard. Okay, I'll protect him.
We're on to the trench of Arenberg.
Allez,
breakaway is losing ground.
On continue. Here we go, here we go.
The next sector, from Wallers to Hélène, also known as the Pont Gibus, in honor of twice Paris-Roubaix winner. Three out of five.
Two seconds.
It is now the longest sector of the race, and one of the most difficult that awaits. To Wandigny, it offers a real opportunity to turn the screw.
Now I have to turn the screw.
I'll make a big effort on the relay. Okay, we'll relay hard.
Okay, I'm coming to protect you.
teammate has just been dropped. You can't count on him any longer. The riders up front still have something left. They're upping the pace to try to hold out till the end.
The head of the race has 1.5 minutes lead on the peloton.
Okay, I'm coming to protect you. I'll avoid any extreme effort.
Looks like the breakaway still has some gas left. It's still able to widen the gap. The approaching sector, from Wallin to Brillion, is 2,400 meters long. When they exit, the riders will have no time for a breather, because there's hardly 1 kilometer before they hit the next sector.
Understood. I'll take it easy, whatever happens. Okay, I'll avoid any extreme effort.
Last time check for the breakaway. 1 minute.
Watch.
Speedy Gonzalez.
The front of the race is
okay.
Sorry, I'm tough. Pretty tough. What? Snavlom, tu bys go vyhýš měl. No.
Seconds lead for the head of the race. It's now the turn of the Orshi sector to welcome the riders. 1,700 meters of cobblestone. In a few kilometers, it will be another key moment for the race with the Mont Pivel sector. However, before that, the four-star sector 11 will have to be crossed.
Okay, I'll consume a feed.
Here we go.
Is decreasing, guys. The peloton should be there for the stage win.
Sector 11 has begun. 2,700 meters from Oshi-les-Orshi to Bersay.
His teammates riding because a rider who's dangerous for the stage victory has broken away.
A very good puncher. He can try to get the upper hand on short climbs, but he can also afford to wait for the sprint given his not inconsiderable speed.
Here we go.
The race is entering the final 50 kilometers, and the next sector is none other than Mont Pivel. Classified as a difficulty 5 and 3 kilometers long, this sector is often described as an ordeal. When it's over, some riders will certainly be eliminated from the list of prospective winners.
If you can this rate, you'll explode. He's got his teammates riding because a rider who's dangerous for the stage victory has broken away. Okay, I'll avoid any extreme effort. A teammate has just been dropped. You can't count on him any longer.
The next sector from Pont Thibault to Ennevelin is 1,400 meters long and carries a 3-star level of difficulty. Last time checked with a breakaway, 1 minute.
Got his teammates riding because in front there's a rider who's dangerous to him in the overall standing.
A 2-star sector is now on the menu. The difficulty of the sectors will then increase until the Carrefour de l'Arbre.
He's got his teammates riding because a rider who's dangerous for the stage victory has broken away.
Lâchez rien. Allez.
less than 30 kilometers to go now for the head of the race, and another 6 sectors to cross. The next 2 sectors, classified as 3 stars, are only 1 kilometer apart. The riders won't have time for a breather. Riders are now heading towards the Carfin-Pivelle and Carrefour-de-Larbe sectors, both often proving decisive for final victory. The front of the race is now entering the Carrefour-Pivelle sector. The riders will then head straight onto the Carrefour de l'Arbre, the final 5-star sector in the race.
He's got his teammates riding because a rider who's dangerous for the stage victory has broken away. It's the Carrefour de l'Arbre, with its 5-star difficulty. This is the last sector that really provides a chance to hurt one's opponents. Very often, the first rider out of this sector goes on to win in Roubaix.
He's got his teammates riding because in front, there's a rider who's dangerous to him in the overall standing.
Penultimate sector for the leading rider. There's only 1 sector left for the rider at the front.
Thank you.
riders are all back together. Everything will be played out in the final kilometers.
They're riding hard behind. This isn't the moment to relax. From the finish for the leaders. It's going to be complicated.
Here's the last sector, 1,400 meters from Willems to Hem. When it's done, there will only be 6 kilometers left before reaching the velodrome.
He's got his teammates riding because in front there's a rider who's dangerous to him in the overall standings.
Another 5 kilometers for the lead rider. He mustn't let up because he doesn't have much of a lead. Bunched peloton. He's accelerating. The race leaders are into the velodrome. Victory will come down to a sprint. One more lap, and it's the finish.
Here we go. The breakaway is at the red pennant.
30 seconds lead for the head of the race.
Alive! Hello! to tame the hell of the North and its cobblestone. Here is the winner of Paris-Roubaix, Oliver Mason. He has added a monument to his list.
Today's result is most unsatisfactory. If things had gone our way, I reckon that we could have got into the top five.